Well, thank you for coming in today to have some discussion about management of the liver tumors that we found in you. So maybe you could start off by just telling me a little bit about what you know about liver tumors and different types of treatment that are available for them.
Well, thank you, doctor, for meeting with me today. I understand that I have cancer because of my history with hepatitis C before, and that there are many treatment options available to me. But I'm a little confused as to how you arrive at the right treatment for me.
Right. Well, that's a great place to start. Let's go ahead and talk a little bit about how we arrive at different treatment decisions for liver tumors. So you can see on this slide, if we look at the right-hand side, that first of all, we start off with being sure there's no cancer outside of the liver. And then when we're dealing with cancer within the liver, looking at the size of individual tumors that a person has, how big they are, as well as how many they have. And then the second thing that we think about is liver function. Some of the treatments can injure the liver, can affect how the liver functions. And so we want to understand how the liver is functioning at baseline. And then the third thing is shown in the orange circle is a person's performance status, how they're doing overall, and if their general health is good. So we'll talk about basically your overall well-being and how functional you are in your everyday life.
Well, so where do I fit on this chart, doctor?
Sure. So your CAT scan is shown kind of to the left of the chart. So that kind of black image on the left-hand side of the screen. Your liver's kind of a dark gray solid structure on the left-hand side. And within your liver, you can see that we've found two tumors. Those are shown by the white arrowheads, and they look like kind of light white, wispy, round areas. So you have two tumors that are about 2 centimeters in size. On the rest of the abdomen, we did not find any evidence of tumors. We also did a CAT scan of the chest, which didn't show any spread of the tumors. So going back to our chart of overall function and so forth, you are functional, you continue to work. Your liver's functioning well, so both of those are good. And so, based on the fact that you have two tumors and good performance status and good liver function, so many of these options of different types of treatment are available to you. So, because you got two tumors and they're in different parts of the liver, generally we're not going to consider surgery for them. But that leaves us with different local treatments that we can use for liver cancer, which are basically the most common treatments that we apply. I can also talk to you a bit about referral for consideration of listing for a liver transplant if that's of interest to you.
Will I need chemotherapy?
So traditional chemotherapies generally reserve for more advanced stages of liver cancer where the cancer is outside of the liver. So we're not going to talk about that specifically today. So let's start with treatments that you can get within your liver locally.
How do they treat the tumors in my liver?
Sure. Let's go back to our to a different slide here. So the first thing that we'll talk about is ablation. So ablation, as shown in the bottom of this slide, basically has two different types. You can see on the slide it says radiofrequency ablation, which is abbreviated RFA, or microwave ablation, which is abbreviated MWA. And so looking at this slide, on the left-hand side, there's a mannequin shown in blue. What's being shown in that diagram is that there's an ultrasound transducer outside of the mannequin. So the ultrasound is used to localize tumor within the liver. And this procedure is done under sedation, either local sedation or general anesthesia. And then an ablation catheter is passed through the skin and into the tumor, guided by the ultrasound. Then in the middle diagram, the tan figure is lying on a table, and you can see that the ablation wand is being placed into a tumor in the liver, and it's hooked up to a machine. So the electrical current is run through the catheter and into the tumor, and the tumor is killed by superheating. And then the blue lines show the heat being pulled back out of the patient and grounded in the machine. The third cartoon over to the right-hand side is of the liver with a tumor in the middle, and there's a small ablation catheter, which is shown getting ready to go into the liver on the right-hand side. So after an ablation, sometimes there can be a bit of discomfort, and sometimes the surgeon or interventional radiologist will recommend that you get admitted to the hospital for observation.
Well, how do we know that the cancer has been treated properly with the use of the wand?
Sure, it's a good question. So basically contrast CAT scans or MRIs are done a number of weeks after the procedure, and those will tell us if the tumor has been well treated. So let's move on to another type of local cancer treatment that I'd also like to tell you about. This one has kind of a long name, which is shown at the top of the slide, which is transarterial chemoembolization, or TACE. And another form of this therapy is transarterial radioembolization, which is called TARE. So as shown in the diagrams on the slide, this type of treatment is done by interventional radiology. As shown on the leftmost panel, they place a small tube or a catheter in an artery, generally in the leg, but at times in the arm, and they advance the catheter as shown on the left-hand slide, up into the main blood vessel, the main artery in the body, which is called the aorta, pass the catheter out the aorta. And as shown in the middle panel, they can access the arteries going into the liver, which give blood to the tumors. So they can pass the catheters out into the liver. And then as shown on the right-hand side, they can inject tiny beads, which are shown in white, directly in the blood vessels, which perfuse the tumor, and that can kill off the tumor, possibly either with chemotherapy or with radiation if it's a radio embolization. So if they decide to use the particles that deliver radiation, you might need a separate appointment before your treatment session. And again, with this procedure, you'll be sedated. After the procedure, pain or nausea are common. And again, they may recommend that you get admitted for observation.
Let me ask you something. If there are all these treatment options available, why do I need a liver transplant? Isn't that difficult to get?
Well, that's true. Let me just briefly mention one other form of local therapy, and that is targeted radiation therapy, which is something else that we sometimes think about. And then we'll talk about liver transplant right after that. So another form of therapy is what we call SBRT, stereotactic body radiation therapy, which is shown on this slide. And in the picture to the right, we see a mannequin lying on a table, and the radiation is the orange light, which is being shown on the slide, basically passing through the mannequin, and it's being used to get targeted radiation into a small area of a tumor, in this case in the liver. And the cartoon on the left-hand side shows a liver with a small tumor in it, and you can see the radiation waves that are being used to target the liver externally. So at times before starting this type of treatment, which is given by radiation oncologists, they may need to inject some tiny markers into the liver near the cancer. You are sedated for that procedure. Sometimes the markers need to be confirmed by CAT scan to be sure that they're placed correctly. Now, in terms of transplant, you're right that the number of patients who need liver transplant is, you know, much greater than the number of organs that are available. So even if we refer you for a liver transplant in the future, it's important to get one of these cancer treatments now. We can certainly discuss liver transplant referral in more detail if you're interested.
Yes, doctor, I'd like to hold off on the transplant. I'm not sure yet. But between the options you discussed, which one do you think would be best for me?
Yeah. Well, I'm going to be talking over your case with some of my colleagues next week. We have our liver tumor board. Let me just mention to you briefly about this. So, like you can see on the slide, we have a multidisciplinary tumor board conference where different clinicians, as shown on the left-hand side of the slide, radiation oncologists, radiologists, medical oncologists, liver specialist surgeons, interventional radiologists get together. And of course, the patient is at the center of that diagram, because the patient's, the person who's, of course, getting the treatment from these different specialists. But we all sit down together or meet together, as shown on the right-hand side of the slide, with blue figures sitting with green figures there, and discuss your case. We'll review your information and make a recommendation for treatment. After the conference, we'll reach out to you about the treatment recommendations and answer any additional questions that you have. You'll also be able to meet with the person who will do your procedure and discuss the process in more detail. There's more information available on the VA official website, www.hepatitis.va.gov, that you can review if you want even more information or have follow-up questions.
Thank you, doctor. I want to thank you for meeting with me today, and I know I'll have more questions when we get to the follow-up.
Yeah, it was my pleasure talking with you, and I'll look forward to working with you as we work our way through this process.